वेलकम बैक। कंटिन्यूइंग इन द फिजिकल लेयर ऑफ द वायरलेस नेटवर्क, वी हैव कंप्लीटिंग टिल स्प्रेड स्पेक्ट्रम कम्युनिकेशन टेक्निक्स एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग द कम्युनिकेशन टेक्निक्स फर्दर। सो अप टिल नाउ इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस टिल दिस पॉइंट टिल एरर कंट्रोल कोडिंग। Now, equalization is a technique which can avoid the inter-symbol interference. As we have discussed that inter-symbol interference is a problem which cannot be handled or overcome by merely increasing the power. Equalization is required to avoid the inter-symbol interference. Inter-symbol interference is basically due to the filtering nature of the channel and limited bandwidth compared to the data rate. So as we try to increase the data rate, ISI becomes worst. So equalization is necessary. So equalization is required at the receiving end, and due to the equalization, our ISI effect are cancelled out, and which results in the error-free communication. Diversity is necessary, particularly in the wireless domain or particularly in the area where interference is larger, and of course we have power constraint. This technique is suitable because the wireless sensor nodes, they have multiple time transmissions in the sensor network. So diversity can be the time diversity or frequency diversity or the space diversity. So time diversity means the same symbol is sent twice or more than one time, so that due to the interference or fading effect, if it is not received once properly, then second time it can be received. Or by combining both the replicas, we can get the better signal than the two. In the similar way, two frequencies are used to transmit the same information, that is frequency diversity. And third one is the space diversity, where we can send the same signal with two or more antennas. These antennas are placed at a distance which is multiple of lambda by 2 or more. So in that way, we can generate two independent channels, and we can take the benefit. So this technique, this is space diversity, is extensively used in the establishment of the higher version of the Wi-Fi. So it is in that way related to the wireless sensor network. Then in the dynamic modulation scaling, that we can do the trade-off. If we do the planning by considering the worst channel, the bad channel, then it may be possible that sometimes channel is good, and unnecessarily we restrict ourselves, or unnecessarily we transmit more power. So we can change the number M, or in the sensor network scenario, we can reduce M during the idle time. When there is no communication, the M can be reduced. And as and when the need of the communication increases, the MRE number, the level of modulation can be increased. Similarly, the antenna with the small form factor, so that it can be put on the small sensor node, and as well as space diversity is also used. And it is necessary to have the omnidirectional antennas, because sometimes the node can be deployed randomly. So in that case, the antennas can be omnidirectional. So with this, we will end this chapter.